But Chelsea always set the standards in the Women's Super League. And Manchester City know that. They beat them here last season. But that merely was the prelude to a winning streak for Chelsea, which is still continuing. It carried them to the title. They are looking for 5 in a row this season. But Manchester City, providing they can keep a settled squad and free of injuries, could be one of the teams to stop them. Of course, they're not involved in the European campaign, and that may just give them the extra time between game weeks to hone things on the training ground. That's something that Gareth Taylor will be hoping for. And he is a coach who really needs a strong challenge in the WSL after missing out in recent years. Two changes for Manchester City from the win at West Ham. Leila Wahabi is suspended and Dana Castellanos drops to the bench. So Philippa Angeldahl and Esme Morgan come in. 19-year-old Kiara Keating continues in goal with Ellie Roebuck not in the squad. But last season's top scorer Bunny Shaw is back on the bench after injury. Erin Cuthbert makes her 200th Chelsea appearance as one of 3 changes from the 2-1 success over Spurs. Jessie Fleming also brings up a century of games for the champions, and her fellow Canadian international Ashley Lawrence makes her full debut following her move from Paris Saint-Germain. Sam Kerr is also on the bench after her World Cup injury, which is ominous news for the rest of the Women's Super League. Beautiful day here in Manchester. A late burst of summer. Gareth Taylor knows that this could be the sort of day when his team really mark themselves down as title contenders. Erin Cuthbert, a player who has helped Chelsea to so much silverware in recent years. And when she's fit, she is always one of the first names on the team sheet. And it's a Chelsea team which has so much depth. City, of course, strengthened their squad with Jill Roord's arrival from Wolfsburg. Couple of years with Arsenal. The Dutch international had success in Germany and should be looking for more here with the sky blue half of Manchester. A sellout crowd at the Academy Stadium. A big day for the officials as well. Emily Heaslip is our referee for this game. And it's Greenwood and Millie Bright. Two England teammates who offer so much experience. And before kick-off, we will have a moment's silence here as a tribute to the former Manchester City player and owner, Francis Lee, who passed away earlier this week.
European Cup Winners' Cup and 2 Charity Shields during a glittering 8-year spell. He would later return to Manchester City as club chairman in 1994, a legacy that ensures his position among Manchester City's all-time greats. Everyone in Manchester City would like to send their condolences to the friends and family of Francis at this very difficult time. There will now be a minute's silence started and stopped by the referee's whistle.
Well, Francis Lee was a true Manchester City great. And a fitting tribute to him there before this game. And Chelsea know this is the first real test of their title credentials this season. It's only the second match of the campaign, but this already feels like a huge game. And it's Chelsea in the dark blue attacking the goal away to our right. And on the attack right from the start, Jill Ward, though, just denying Lauren James. And the cross into the penalty area is claimed by Kiara Keating, the England under 19 international. And of course, she will be under the spotlight today with one of the main stories around Manchester City, the non-inclusion of Ellie Roebuck, not even in the matchday squad today, having been on the bench for the loss, or for the victory, at West Ham last week. There is Ellie Roebuck watching on today with Sandy McIver on the bench. Was her backup for so much of last season. Fowler. Solid challenge coming in from Carter. And there'll be a high degree of physicality at the start of this game as both teams try to win the ascendancy. Greenwood, now Roard. City moving the ball around sweetly initially, but it's quickly cut out by Sophie Ingle. Not so much of her job. And she's now only three games behind Keris Harrop on the all-time list of women's Super League appearances. She will surely overhaul that this season. Moskovic with the clearance. And Katrin Berger continuing on the Chelsea bench. Fowler. Yeah, the cross in is cleared away initially, but then it's fired through and the deflection causing a problem there for Moskovic. Jill Roard with the effort. And it's hammered away to safety by Bright in the end. Clever play between Fowler and Hemp on this near side, and then Moskovic just happy to palm the ball down, and Bright taking no chances with Chloe Kelly lurking. First corner for Manchester City. Greenwood will take it in towards the near post area. Cuthbert, who managed to clear away, back towards Greenwood again. It's hung up and then eventually cleared before Angledal returns it. Roard is in there, and then the volley towards goal is turned aside by Moskovic again. And she's been very busy in the opening stages. Strong start here from Manchester City, which continues with Fowler. Now Hasegawa. Chloe Kelly with the Cruyff turn before she just runs out of room, and it will be a throw-in, but we've already seen Manchester City go close twice, and it was Lauren Hemp who strikes the ball so cleanly. And she scored a spectacular goal here against Chelsea in March in the 2-0 success. Morgan. Now Kennedy. And the home crowd really gaining encouragement from the way their team have started here. City had not beaten Chelsea for 11 games before the 2-0 win here back in March. Although this has never been a place where Chelsea have enjoyed significant success, only one win in their previous 10 visits, plenty of draws in that. They did win here 4-0 back in November of 2021 when City were full of injuries and really out of form as Chelsea looked to come forward here, but Wrighton will only guide it through towards Keating. Since that loss against City, Chelsea have won 8 games in a row. Carter with the clearance. Sam Kerr on the bench today. Frank Kirby, another option for Chelsea. Just giving you an indication of the depth they have. 54 in 67 in the Women's Super League. It's a remarkable record. Kelly. By Angledahl. It's back towards Kelly again and she lets fly again! What a strike and what a goal! Well, she never seems to score tap-ins. And that goal has been coming since the very first whistle. And the champions are behind once again at the Academy Stadium. And Chloe Kelly was given so much room, 20 yards from goal. It was Cuthbert who never really got close enough to her. And from the moment she let fly, well, it took a deflection off Carter to loop over Muscovich. And I think she may have been beaten by the pace of it anyway. A bit of loop there from Carter and Muscovich looking into the sun. Unable to keep it out. And Manchester City have the early lead against Chelsea. Cuthbert. Now Fischl involved for the first time. James, Lawrence, Keating stays at home and Morgan has to concede the corner. And for the first time we've really seen Chelsea move forward as an attacking force and teasing ball in from Ashley Lawrence. It's clearly going to be a very good signing for Chelsea. In the corner, helped on at the near post by Charles, but City are able to smuggle the ball away. Lawrence. Now Fowler. Bright. James coming short. It's a difficult one to deal with, and Fischl was causing problems there. Eventually, Alexandri is able to intercept, and then eventually it's cleared. But here is Bright again. We've seen already that this is going to be a contest of high intensity. It's through towards Fischl on the edge of the penalty area. She goes down, but Wrighton almost wins it back. And in the end, it's swooped on by Keating. Agura Wrighton has such a good goal-scoring record from playing wide on the left-hand side. James. It's all the way back to Muscovic. He made two early saves but had very little chance there with the deflected shot from Chloe Kelly. Comes out by Fowler. And that's a smart turn away from Charles. Charles looking to pull her back, but Fowler continues. Hemp. Kelly pulling away to the left. And eventually, Lauren James with the challenge, and it's a free kick in a very dangerous area. And at the moment, Chelsea just having problems with the movement from midfield for Manchester City. Lauren James picks up a yellow card. That movement from midfield which is causing the problems. Fowler joining up in the centre. That was a contributory factor to the goal. Now Muscovic will have to deal with this free kick. Kennedy is over it. Greenwood making her 100th Manchester City appearance. There's another option as well, of course. But it's Greenwood, and in the end it's comfortable for Muscovic. Maybe favoured Kennedy to try and hit it right-footed from that sort of angle. Chelsea looking to play out, and they've given the ball away again. Morgan, Roard, now Fowler. Chelsea will try and bring the ball away. Fischl will chase, but it's cleared away by Kennedy. Gareth Taylor watching alongside Sean Gota, to Manchester City strikers from the past. Fischl, who was prolific in Mexican football. She's drawn Kennedy to the wide area. Kennedy is able to recover, and she's helped out by Hasegawa. Fischl looking to roll the challenge of Kennedy, who stuck with her at the expense of a corner. Maya Fischl, 47 goals in 64 games for Tigres in Mexico. She came through at UCLA. She was drafted by Orlando but chose not to take up the option and moved to a club where she may be able to compete for trophies, which she certainly did. And she's joined another club, certainly in that category. Cuthbert will take the corner. Bright among those four, Keating coming through the crowd. Wrighton. Do for Alexandri. Lawrence. She was caught as she played it forward, but play continues, and now Lawrence has to try and get back. Kelly using the ball well again. The cross in from Angle Dahl. It's not been cleared conclusively. Fowler looking to turn onto the right foot, and in the end it scrambled away. For Mary Fowler, who was a perennial sub last season, really enjoying her starts in the new campaign. The initial clearance from Carter, falling to her. She was just looking to wriggle away from Ingle, which is easier said than done. Kelly with the corner, pinged in and helped on. Hasegawa. And again, it wasn't defended convincingly, but Muzovic is able to gather. Yui Hasegawa really came to prominence in the Women's Super League with a spectacular long-range goal here for West Ham a couple of years ago. Kennedy breaks for Cuthbert. Now Bright. Now James. Hayes watching on, right on the edge of the technical area. Carter. Chelsea finding it very difficult to play out at the moment. They are much more effective when they try to be more direct. Fleming was caught there. It will be a free kick. And it's another yellow card. Emily Heaslip laying down the law in the early stages. Late from Greenwood. Lawrence. James. And the ball had gone out. Chelsea fans here today supporting their team. Now Cuthbert. James. Manchester City have had 4 shots on target already in this game. Spurs had 11 in the game last week at Stamford Bridge. And Chelsea have only faced more on 2 occasions. Those matches were both over a decade ago, but Manchester City have started here with real attacking intent. But here is Fleming, and it's cut out by Greenwood. Cuthbert. Now Lawrence. Charles. Right, looking for that big switch, but it was cut out by Morgan. Now Kennedy. This time it's beyond Lauren Hemp. And it will be interesting to see Gareth Taylor switches things around when only Shaw is fully fit. City do have an array of attacking talents now that could all put their hands up and say they deserve to be in the starting lineup. But it's all about finding the right blend. That was the earlier challenge by Greenwood on Fleming, which earned her the yellow card. Bright, straight to Fowler. Roared. Asagawa once again. So much for City coming down their left-hand side with Kelly. She's helped out by Roared, but here is Lawrence. In towards Fischl, but a solid challenge from the retreating Kennedy, and Manchester City quickly have the ball back. Just joined us, Manchester City taking an early lead. It's to Chloe Kelly. Took a deflection, but it was a really good strike. That ball has stayed in play, and Carter has to take evasive action under pressure from Lauren Hemp. Morgan will take the throw-in. Player who has come back really strongly from that horrible broken leg a couple of years ago. Charles. And Fleming. Fischl. Greenwood stepping in. Now Fischl again. She was looking to release Fleming, but Chelsea have not quite got the details right so far in this game. It's going to be a very busy season for Chelsea. They'll be starting the group stage of the UEFA Women's Champions League in November. Of course, they qualify as of right. Arsenal have already gone out in the qualifiers, losing to Paris FC. And Manchester United will be facing Paris Saint-Germain in their final qualifier, so one big club won't be in the group stage. But she's closed down again by Hemp. And Millie Bright, one of the most decorated players in women's football. Six titles with Chelsea. And you have to go back to players involved in that dominant Arsenal team a decade ago to really find anyone else who comes close. Asagawa. She's used the ball very well so far. Morgan. Now Fowler. Carter is able to clear. Now Charles. Chelsea not having a moment to breathe on the ball. Lawrence. Quickly closed down by Kelly, so she has to head back towards her own goal. Ingle. James. Now Fleming, right into her left. Fischl waits in the centre. Here is Fleming again. Fischl just crowded out at the near post by Greenwood. Chelsea always more effective when they go down their right-hand side. Combinations like this. Fleming and Writing, it was Fleming in the end, and Green were just getting the foot in to deny Fischl. Cuthbert's corner in towards Bright. And it's loose inside the six-yard area. Fischl was almost in there. Charles. Now Cuthbert again. And the angle's opened up for James. Closed down by Hasegawa, but James able to fire the shot in, blocked by Kennedy. And the cross back into Ingle. Good save by Keating. And then Carter is denied. Now Bright. It's cleared by Morgan. That's Chelsea's best moment so far. And Kiara Keating improvising to deny Sophie Ingle. Lawrence. James. That's a rarity from Aaron Cuthbert. But the shot from Lauren James causing confusion. It was Charles who found Ingle and the knees of Keating. Keeping City ahead. The way this game is going, one goal does not look to be enough for the home side at the moment. Vucevic with the clearance. He's met by City head Greenwood and tidied up by Morgan. City will next be in action on Wednesday, away to Everton in the WSL Cup. And they have a home game with Bristol City here next in the WSL. But they travel to both Arsenal and Manchester United in November. It's a very busy start to the season for them. Fowler. Trying to maintain possession again. It's won back by Cuthbert. Finding three sky blue shirts around her, now four, but she still comes away with the ball with the help of Cuthbert. Lauren James gliding forward here. Wrighton, so many waiting for the cross, but it was dug out by Kennedy. Cuthbert. Ball from Bright. Wrighton. Good challenge from Morgan. But it's a fourth corner for Chelsea. And Esme Morgan could maybe do with some more cover down the City right-hand side. Carter and Bright up from the back once again, along with Charles. Cuthbert's delivery, Fleming, Charles. And Cuthbert again, she can really whip this ball in. But it's met by Greenwood. James. Losing out to Kelly. So many of these players, of course, on both sides were involved in the England squad at the World Cup, so they know each other's game inside out. Charles helped away at the far post, only as far as Cuthbert. And it's deflected away, it's another corner. Defended convincingly by Alexandri, but Cuthbert was quickly closed down. Brighton's delivery, and the bodies went tumbling before the ball arrived, and a free kick's been given. Neve Charles was closest to it. Carter was the player who was involved at the near post, holding on to Greenwood, who quickly went down. I'm not sure that Mary Fowler knew too much about the block, but the whistle had already gone. Chelsea played in front of nearly 15,000 at Stamford Bridge last week, and another big crowd here today at the Academy Stadium. The game is living up to the billing so far. Kick, but it's cleared away by Bright. Lauren Hemp, the player who was fouled. Kennedy. Official was maybe looking for more support there in the press. By Lawrence. Broad. Spreading it nicely. Fowler going beyond Charles deep into the penalty area. But in the end, it was Jess Carter who helped her out, and it's a corner. The Australian internationals had a storming start to this game. Using that pace once again on the outside. Neve Charles needed the assistance of Jess Carter there. Greenwood will try and curl this one in. Short in the end. Cross aim towards Roard, and in the end the header was off balance, and as a result off target. Yeah, Alexandri, the player who was never really set to hit the target from there. Tidied up by Kennedy, and you could hear Gareth Taylor there urging Mary Fowler to close down Erin Cuthbert, which is easier said than done at times. James. Such a good mover when she's got the ball at her feet. Charles. Of course, he's met by Angle Dahl, and then there was a late challenge on the edge of the penalty area. It will be a free kick, and it's another yellow card, the third in the first half. This one for Neve Charles. Anything late has been punished here. And it was Chloe Kelly who was caught, got the ball first. Ingle. Official.
Yes, Mary.
James losing out to Fowler. Greenwood. She takes the safer option. Keeping situation for City is a fascinating one. Kiara Keating, the youngest of the three, with Sandy McKeever on the bench today, and Ellie Roebuck not involved at all. The final touch there was off Angle Dahl, who scored her first goal in the Women's Super League against Chelsea last season. A big crowd here enjoying the autumnal sunshine. Extremely warm for the time of year. This is penalised for the challenge from behind. The ideal sort of player for this sort of game. Greenwood over the free kick. She's encouraged to get on with things. And Greenwood here is going to receive a yellow card, and she's already been booked in the game, and it's a red card. And the Manchester City captain has been sent off a second yellow card for time wasting. Leila Alexander has also been shown a red card for dissent. And that's a real twist late in the first half here. Alex Greenwood, who was booked early on in the game, maybe just delayed the free kick, and Emily Heaslip, who has been dishing out the cards with regularity throughout the first half, showed Alex Greenwood a second yellow very quickly, and Manchester City are down to 10 players. Well, this was the incident. Greenwood took the free kick, but by then Heaslip has decided that she'd taken too long. There are directives which the players are aware of about time wasting this season. And the referee clearly believed that Alex Greenwood was taking too long. She was over that free kick for 17 seconds. And as a result, she's shown a yellow card. And she's off. Gareth Taylor has to reorganise here. And Emma Hayes very quickly brought her players in to discuss how to attack City's 10 players. Well, that is a decision which will be talked about for a long time following this game. But 17 seconds is beyond the accepted time to take a free kick. We don't often see players penalised for time wasting in the first half of games, but Emily Heaslip clearly believed that Greenwood was looking to manage the clock, and the City captain has been dismissed. And in the aftermath, Alexandre also received a yellow card for dissent. So in total, we've seen five yellow cards in the first half, including the two given to Greenwood, which added up to a red. It's never dull when these two teams meet, and it's certainly not been here today. James. Now Lawrence. Cuthbert. James again. City have had to reorganise, and Greenwood was playing at the heart of their defence, so that's a gap they'll need to plug. Cuthbert, Ingall. Just look how deep City are now. Maybe just looking to get to half time before they can really regroup. But Alexandre wins it back. But their sense of perceived injustice will certainly fire up the home crowd. Alexandre is dropped into the centre as a central defender at the moment, with Lauren Hemp operating in a deeper role. Cuthbert. Hasegawa and Fowler looking to protect the back line, and Jill Ward may take the role as the front runner. Bright. And in the end, it bounces away to safety. Gareth Taylor was looking to reorganise. The central figure in the first half has been Emily Heaslip, the referee. You can start counting from the moment the free kick was given. And then Greenwood was over the ball. And that clock is still ticking beyond 10 seconds, up towards 15. And by now, Emily Heaslip had lost patience. Showed her the second yellow card. Lawrence. And when you look at things in isolation like that, you can see that Alex Greenwood, irrespective of who you support, did take her time. And players, coaches, even commentators sat through meetings at the start of the season with the main officials' body for English football, for both men's and women's football, to discuss the new directives, and that was one of them. Here is Kelly. What can the 10 players do here? Fowler looking to get forward, only Roard in the centre. It's met by Bright. Kelly. Now Hemp, who was operating as the left back. Alexandre's dropped into the centre now. Fowler. There's a City player down, and it's Chloe Kelly, nothing given. Hemp, now Kelly, almost spun away from Lawrence, and she delivers the cross in. And Ingle will eventually clear, but straight to Hasegawa. Well, we set up for a fascinating second half now. The goal from Chloe Kelly seems a long time ago. Charles. City have gone to a back three with Hemp on one side as Alexandre plays it back towards Keating. Morgan has dropped into the middle. With Angledale trying to provide some width down the right. Hemp. Broad. No free kick. Fleming. To a minimum of 3 minutes added time. Wrighton. Fischel allows it to run, but there was nobody behind her. Right. Now Lawrence. James. Official strikes Alexandre. Lawrence. Alexandre diving in to concede the corner. What a first half we have had for so many reasons. Corner cleared as far as Cuthbert. Now James to her right. Now Lawrence. James in towards Fischel, but headed away by Kennedy. James. Now Fleming. Lawrence. City in full retreat at the moment. Angledale, who is the wing-back, will have to try and track both Wrighton and Fleming for a moment. Charles. And here is Wrighton. Fischel! And it's wide. Well, Maya Fischel has been feeding off scraps at times, but she... managed to get a toe to that, the cross in from Wrighton, but it gently rolled across the face of goal. Emma Hayes will be wondering just how her team can make the extra player work in the second half. Doesn't always, of course, guarantee a result. We've seen Chelsea come from behind with 10 players in recent years. Kelly. Now Roard. And that is half time. Well, it's not been dull. The early goal from Chloe Kelly for Manchester City, but Emily Heaslip, the referee, sending off Alex Greenwood, two yellow cards, and now she has booked Jill Roard after the whistle had gone for kicking the ball away. And she flourished the yellow card, the referee, from the very early moments. Now Roard is the latest recipient. And Greenwood was sent off, the second yellow card for time wasting. And she took some time to take a free kick. And Manchester City must play the entire second half with 10 players, but crucially, they're a goal up, thanks to Chloe Kelly. Don't miss this second half, half-time. Manchester City 1, Chelsea 0.
Thank you.
Emma Hayes may not have been happy with a number of issues in the first half, but she's making the double change, and Sam Kerr will be unleashed once again in the Women's Super League. Sophie Ingle is the first player to go off. Pankovic will maybe be a slightly more mobile presence in midfield. Sam Kerr, who picked up a calf injury at the Women's World Cup, she comes on for Mia Fischel. And a change for City as well. And it's Kirsten Kasperi, the Dutch international, who has come on for them. And she has come on for Mary Fowler. Gareth Taylor may be making a slightly more defensive change to his midfield as they look to see this game out with 10 players. The 10 players of Manchester City get the second half underway, leading by a goal to nil against the reigning champions Chelsea. And Chelsea in the dark blue shirts attacking the goal away to our left in the second half. If you've just joined us, where have you been? Chloe Kelly with a spectacular early goal for Manchester City. But Alex Greenwood, their captain, was sent off, a second yellow card for time wasting late in the first half. And it was a first half littered with yellow cards. The referee, Emily Heaslip, as Cuthbert looks to release Wrighton. The crossing was deflected and claimed by Keating. And changes made by both teams at half time. Sam Kerr on the field for Chelsea. That's one of two changes. Gura Wrighton with the first cross in. And it was deflected kindly for City. City look to defend their lead here. Maybe pick up what they can on the counter-attack. Here is Hasegawa on towards the goal scorer Kelly. Now Angeldal, and that pass didn't really help out Hasegawa. James with that long ball looking for Kerr. Keating choosing to volley the ball away from outside her penalty area. Hemp, who is now filling in as a left back as the defensive reorganisation. And it's a good ball forward looking for Chloe Kelly. No real support, but Kelly strikes it, and it's saved by Muzovic. Well, City do have players still on the field capable of a moment of genius, and Chloe Kelly is certainly one of those. She, Jill Roard, and Leila Alexandri, all on yellow cards. Five were shown to City in total during the first half, two of those for their captain Alex Greenwood. And Neve Charles and Lauren James also saw yellow for Chelsea. Cuthbert, now Wrighton, of course playing 10 against 11 is a regular training drill for both sets of players to try and break teams down and also try to overcome the extra player. Angeldal looking for Kelly. She's taken over as the lone striker, with Angeldal and Roard looking to get close to her when they can. Hasegawa will float around as the number 10. Cuthbert. It was cut out initially, but it's back to Wrighton. And now James, it could open up. It's James, but it was brilliant defending from Kennedy. Hammered away by Morgan in the end. And it seemed to open up there for Lauren James. Wrighton picked her out, and that curler to the far post seemed to have opened up, but Kennedy to the rescue as the cross in is eventually hammered to safety. Now Charles, and I would imagine we will see plenty of action around the City penalty area in the second half. Here is Hasegawa, run off it by Cuthbert. Now Kankovic. James. She was challenged and the free kick's given. Engeldahl, the player who went down. Lauren James, one of the Chelsea players, on a yellow card, and every time a player goes down, it will be heart-in-mouth time for those players who've already been booked. Long from Keating, but it will come straight back, Carter. But now Hasegawa. Kasparai, good ball. Hasegawa. Cut out by Lawrence. City will not be rushing the restart, but they know they can't take too long. Challenge from Hemp. Now Roard. Hasegawa. Roard. Kelly in support. Oh, and she was looking for Hemp to make the overlapping run, but she'd stayed where she was. Emily Heaslip also booked Jill Roard after the whistle had gone for the end of the first half for booting the ball into the stand. Cuthbert. All the way back towards Keating. Kennedy was almost bled into trouble there, but now Keating takes the ball away. Charles. Kankovic, Lawrence, Fleming looking for Wrighton, cleared as far as Cuthbert, and it's too high. And again, it was defended well by Morgan. Cuthbert closed down by Engeldahl, and maybe that was just enough. I think she's okay. Charles. Wrighton. Keating again. Thought about coming, then retreated. City were looking for a handball there, but it continues. Charles. Now Wrighton. It's very deep. Kerr is there looking for Fleming, and Keating claims well. And there's plenty of room for Wrighton if she wants it down the left-hand side. Sam Kerr pulling away, and it was Fleming arriving, but Keating's had a decent game so far. She's been involved in some very testing situations already in her career. Still only 19 years of age, but she's packed a lot in. Charles closed down by Kasparai. Will believe that she's got the quality on the team now to get back into this game and win it. Lawrence. Well read by Kennedy. Charles. Kankovic. Lifted by Bright. Lawrence looking for Kerr. She believed that Hemp had used her hand there, but nothing given by the referee. Kerr. Hemp again helping out. Started the game as the centre forward, now she's the fullback. Frank Kirby is warming up. She's coming back from knee surgery. Scored 6 times in 8 games last season. And she did score here when Chelsea won 4-0 back in November 2021. Along with Jessie Fleming, Sam Kerr. Magdalena Eriksson, who has departed since to Bayern Munich, along with Daniela Harder. Chelsea did bring in 9 signings during the transfer window, 7 different nationalities, adding to an already cosmopolitan squad. Charles, she's away from the challenge, but again, there's no Chelsea player on the end of it. But it seems the pattern has been set for the second half. Manchester City setting Chelsea the challenge of breaking them down. It's a 5-3-1 formation. That three are often very deep. Charles. Right turn, Cuthbert in towards Kerr, but a good header away by Kennedy. Lawrence, well, she was late, and the crowd are baying for a yellow card here. Well, we did see challenges like that booked in the first half. Lauren Hemp, the player who was caught. Lauren Hemp is still down. Cuthbert lifting the ball in. He's met by Kennedy. Lawrence. Well, she took out Hemp. After the heavy first touch. We did see challenges like that, punished with a yellow card in the first half. And Lauren Hemp looks to be in some trouble here. It may be a shoulder problem from the way she fell rather than the impact of the challenge. Another problem for Gareth Taylor here. Lawrence there just pushing the ball away, and then she tried to recover and Hemp came in, and it was a challenge which was certainly late. And then Hemp landing heavily on her right shoulder. treatment continuing here for Lauren Hemp. Chelsea are about to make another change. Melanie Leopolds will be coming on, so they'll be freshening up the midfield. And it's Aaron Cuthbert who comes off. Leopolds, the German international. Jesse Fleming is also replaced by Frank Kirby, so Emma Hayes is really rolling out the big guns here as her team chase the match. Lauren Hemp heading across to the far side. Ashley Lawrence seemingly has not been shown a yellow card. Well, Chelsea have brought on so many talented players in the second half, but they're yet to really test Ciara Keating. City have done well to keep them at bay here. City have got through 15 minutes, but they still have half an hour to play. But we've seen Chelsea in this sort of situation in the past just gradually wear the opposition down and emerge as the winners. Charles. Leopolds. Bright. Leopolds again. Away from Hasegawa. City go long, but there's nobody anywhere near it. And that's the problem they have here. They are so deep to try and keep out Chelsea that when they do play the ball forward, Lawrence, and this time Hemp is able to get the challenge here, and then it loops kindly into the arms of Keaton. Lauren Hemp with three goals and three assists in her previous four home games against Chelsea, but she's in a more defensive role now. Charles. Charles again. Chelsea with well over 60% possession now in this game. It's won back well by Raud. Hasegawa. Kelly. Angledahl. Kasparai given a lot to do there, and Charles gets there first. Right. Once again, another Chelsea attack flounders, but City give them the ball straight back. City had four shots on target very early on in the game, but won since. That's from inside the opening 15 minutes. Chelsea with 10 shots so far, but only one on target. And that was the header from Sophie Ingle in the first half, which was blocked by the knees of Kiara Keating. But that clock must be moving very slowly for Manchester City at the moment. Kirby, she can't find Kurt. Frank Kirby, a player who's had so much to deal with in the last couple of years, but when she is fully fit, she remains one of the best players in the game. Hasegawa. Oh, and that back pass could cause problems. Keating a long way out, and Keating gets there before Kerr. And the teenager had to make a decision there, and she did. Lawrence, now Leopolds, Charles, Hasegawa has been knocked off it by James, but now Hasegawa has the ball back. Every ball forward needs to be precise, and Kelly had made the run to the right, and Hasegawa only really had an avenue going the other way. Kankovic. Leopolds, unable to turn away from the challenge of Rod. Lawrence. Now Leopolds again. Kirby. And Chelsea want the corner. And they get it. And Lauren Hemp has shown a yellow card. For contesting the award, and Manchester City would do well not to say anything to the officials at the moment, I think. Kirby. And there were new directives at the start of the season about descent, and there was an indication given to the players and everybody else that it would be clamped down on, and that has been the case in the early weeks of the season in both men's and women's football. Hemp. Now Hasegawa. Broad, Alexandri. Morgan. And this is what City need to do here to maintain possession and just try and take time off the clock. And they've got through first quarter of the second half here, but now Lawrence briefly away from Hemp, but Hemp recovers well. But Lawrence has won it back from Hemp. Chelsea have loaded the penalty area, but the cross doesn't find anybody. Well, Lauren Hemp is having a real battle with Ashley Lawrence. That shoulder may be causing a problem for her, but she's the sort of player who will not want to give an inch. And players like her and Alana Kennedy are showing real leadership at the moment. As Chelsea make another change, and it's Eve Parasek who has come on to replace Ashley Lawrence. So two players who were starring in the French league in recent years. Parasek, of course, with both Lyon and PSG. It will be another problem for Lauren Hemp to try and solve. But City have got to within the final 20 minutes here. Kelly's been fouled and they get the free kick. And the question is, how many players do they send forward? Kelly, Hemp and Raud are over it. And they play it short and they're looking to maintain possession here. Raud, Hemp on the line looking for Kelly. And the boot was raised and the flag was up for offside. The Chelsea have created very little in the second half, despite having so many attacking players on the field now. Kerr, Kirby. They've not really had a sniff. Sam Kerr's the sort of player who can go through a game with very few opportunities and then take the one that comes along. Here is Wrighton. And the cross again is poor. City have only made one change so far, with Kasperi coming on for Fowler at half-time. And Chelsea have made four. Hasegawa. Kerr working hard to win it back. And it's cleared, and Kelly will chase here with Carter. Kelly has got there first. No support for her, but Kelly will look to go herself. Carter recovers with a challenge, and that's excellent defending. Didn't panic and got the job done. That's the sort of opportunity that Manchester City must look to now. Just look at that line of world-class talent that Chelsea have going forward, but they don't receive the ball. Leopolds, though, will ensure they get the throw-in. And this is still a game that Chelsea will believe they can win from here. They've got that sort of mentality. Kennedy concedes the free kick, it's taken quickly. Charles. And in the end, Morgan just happy to hammer the ball to safety. She and Kennedy have been magnificent for Manchester City in the second half. Tactically, Gareth Taylor has got things spot on. James. And that cross was nowhere near any of the dark blue shirts. This was the opportunity for Kelly, but Jess Carter did superbly and then timed that challenge. Anything less than that and she would have been sent off as well. Wrighton. It was blocked and City will squirt the ball away. Angledar with the challenge. There's real tension now at the Academy Stadium. There has been throughout the second half. Hasegawa losing out. Kirby was looking for that through ball, slid in for Kerr, but it doesn't come off. And now City will try and break with Lauren Hemp. Just looking to carry the ball a long way. Swirled in towards Kelly. Beaten to it though by Carter. Kirby. Here is Wrighton. And we're looking for Kerr again, but it was cut out by her fellow Australian Kennedy. Charles. Leopolds. Kirby again, but it's beyond Kerr. That's the ball they're looking for. And Keating may have a problem here. And play has been stopped. As we tick into the final 15 minutes. Keating coming out. Maybe she pulled something as she slid along the turf there. So this will add time on the clock. City look for their bench for only the second time in the game. Alaman is giving the instructions. But Manchester City have defended so well, and Bonnie Shaw will be coming on to try and give them another option in attack, or maybe the option in attack. She wasn't involved due to injury last week. Kiara Keating. Back on her feet, she'll be okay to continue. City will make their changes first. Well, their play will continue. There was a delay of over 2 minutes there, which will be reflected in the added time at the end of the game. Hemp losing out to Kankovic, Leopolds. Here is Bright. Manchester City's sole focus in the second half has been defending. And so far they've managed to keep the champions out. Kankovic. Chelsea have not failed to score in the Women's Super League since they lost here back in March. James, left-footed curler, off the crossbar. And that's the closest they've come in the second half. Kerr. Back to Kankovic. And Angledal will bring the ball away. And that's the sort of ball they're looking for, just to play for territory. But Lauren James, we've seen that before. The left-footed curler. Keating was nowhere. And it thudded back off the crossbar. Almost a lazy swing of the left boot, but there's real intent. There's real menace in that. But Chelsea remain scoreless. As Chloe Kelly is one of the players to make way. And Bonnie Shaw will come on. 20 goals in the Women's Super League last season. And the Jamaican international comes on with 11 minutes to play. And Ruby Mace replacing Philippa Angeldal. Keating denying James again, as two City players end up on the turf in addition to the keeper. Lauren Hemp is one of those players who is soldiering on. Gareth Taylor has been very quick to bide his time before making changes in the second half, maybe not wanting to disrupt what has been a very good defensive unit. But Ruby Mace had a very good loan spell with Leicester City last season, helped them to survival in the Women's Super League. Came through the academy at Arsenal before helping Birmingham to safety 3 seasons ago now, when she was a 17-year-old. I remember her scoring a couple of crucial goals. James has been hauled down by Hemp. And it's another red card for Lauren Hemp this time. A second yellow card, and Manchester City are down to 9 players. Nine minutes to go, 9 players left. And Gareth Taylor must be wondering what on earth is happening. Hemp joins Greenwood on the sidelines, and she was holding back Lauren James, but I'm sure that Lauren Hemp is thinking about the earlier challenge from Ashley Lawrence on her, which did not result in a yellow card. But Hemp, who started as the centre forward, ends up as the fullback and doesn't finish the game. City are down to 9 as Chelsea go close to an equaliser, but the ball has gone behind. Well, this is extraordinary. This was the free kick which was played in, and it was Bunny Shaw who maybe got the final touch. Well, Emily Heaslip, the referee, has been a real headline maker here, but I'm not sure that she would want to be. Corner kick for Chelsea. A goal down, but 2 extra players now. Kirby losing out to Shaw. And Bunny Shaw looking to lead a counter-attack. Fresh legs from her, of course, but it's Millie Bright who comes back, and it's all the way back towards Zakira Muzovic, who has been a spectator. Kirby. Now James, but it's cut out, and City will try and bring it forward with Rod. Now Mace. The home crowd are urging them forward now. Kasparai. Mace may just prefer to head to the corner flag, but she's gone beyond Kankovic. She delivers the cross for Shaw, and she wasn't too far away from a second. It's a corner kick, and the 9 players almost made the game safe. Well, it was a really good breakaway. Ruby Mace would have been forgiven for heading for the corner flag, but she played the cross in. And Bunny Shaw nearly applied the finish. 2 players have recently come off the bench. And it was Perisay who got to Shaw just in time. 2 former Bordeaux teammates in France. Well, whatever happens now, it is going to be a story. Rod is trying to hold the ball, and in the end she's lost out. But Chelsea lose possession. It was Kankovic. Julie Blackstad will be coming on, and Emma Hayes looking for her team to step it up here. Blackstad will come on. And it's Jill Roard who comes off. Well, she's on a yellow card, so maybe that's wise. But in total, City have been shown 6 yellow cards in this game, and of course 2 of them have led to reds. Hasegawa, what a game she's had. Now Mace, in towards Shaw, and Shaw almost gets it from Perisic, but it's won back by Hasegawa. The 9 players moving forward again here. Blackstad just happy to go to the corner flag, and she's drawn both James and Perisic towards her, and eventually it's James who comes away with the ball. Now Wrighton. Surely Chelsea have got to make this numerical advantage pay here. Carter. Now Perisic. Keating comes and claims. Well, you rarely get such a level of intensity from the crowd like this, but the Manchester City support have really got behind their side here. Well, did Perisic use a hand there as Shaw controlled? Three and a half minutes to play. The champions a goal down, but facing 9 players. In towards Bright, who's now forward as an extra striker. Shaw will chase, but Muzovic will get there first. James in towards Kerr. City get themselves in a tangle. Bright with a looping header, but it's claimed by Keating. Well, it's been a game which will be talked about for years. Whatever happens now. Long from Keating. Kankovic. Perisic. City have been a player down since the 38th minute, 2 players down since the 81st minute. And Chelsea still haven't scored. But there's still time for them. Perisic. Kirby! And it deflects through to Keating. Well, Emma Hayes will not be happy with the performance, whatever happens. The team have dominated possession. It's been over 60% since the first red card, but 2 shots on target. Kerr wins the knockdown, but she can't find Bright. Keating just looking to eat up the clock as we head into the 90th minute. What a performance from Manchester City to defend like they have Mace. Foul by Leopolds, it's a free kick. And City will look to take their time, but of course not too much time. And very shortly, Chelsea will be living off added time in this game. Long towards Shaw, cleared by Carter. Now Wrighton, well, she's given the ball away. Mace again. Leopolds. Carter. Now James. James, Kerr and Kirby, all on the field for Chelsea. Wrighton. We're into 8 added minutes. And Keating claims. And the cross in from Wrighton. Claimed by the goalkeeper. And she has not missed a thing so far, but there's still the best part of 8 minutes to play. Gareth Taylor will have learnt so much about his team during this game. Through towards Shaw again. And she's got support. Kasparai. Just taking it towards that corner flag. Oh, but now she's given the ball away. Here is Wrighton. Leopolds. And the ricochet is kind for Manchester City. Hasegawa. Carter. Manchester City retreat once again. Wrighton. Now Kennedy. Shaw. And Mace just getting the job done. City have got time to reset. Charles. Wrighton. The cross deflected. Met by Hasegawa. Charles. And again, Chelsea are crowded out. And City have negotiated 2 of the 8 added minutes. Perisic. Charles. Looking to tease Kasparai. She's helped out by Kirby. Charles with the cross. Bright was challenging, but Kennedy got there first. Charles back in towards Bright. And back to Charles. Now Kirby. Perisic. James. High in towards Bright. And the header off the crossbar again. Kerr. And she fails to make contact. And it's sliced away by Kennedy. It's a corner kick. But when it fell to Sam Kerr, he would have backed on her hitting the target there. The header from Bright looping onto the bar and then Kerr failing to make clean contact. And Manchester City have a real escape there. And it was a great challenge by Hasegawa in fairness. Corner kick. Just look how many dark blue shirts are lined up inside that area. But there is a problem here for Alana Kennedy, and no wonder she's got cramp, because she has harried, marshalled and kept Chelsea out. And Emma Hayes has seen her side blunted for long spells despite the numerical advantage. And Gareth Taylor has seen his side hold out at the moment. But there's still time for Chelsea. There's no doubt that all the contenders for player of the match have been City players, and Ciara Keating would be one of them. In the midst of all the pressure, she has managed to cling on to every cross. But now it is a corner kick for Chelsea. And there will be extra time added on to the end of the 8 minutes. And the corner's whipped in, and the header clawed away brilliantly by Keating, but it's still loose inside the penalty area. Wrighton with the shot, and Chelsea finally have the equaliser. Goro Wrighton in the 96th minute. Keating finally beaten. And Chelsea will still believe there's a winning goal in this game. The initial header from Bright kept out brilliantly by Keating, but City could not get the ball away. And in the end, Wrighton's shot managed to find its way through. There were so many bodies between her and the goal. And it was in through the legs of Hasegawa in the end. And Chelsea, right at the very end, have the equaliser. And have they got time to try and win this game? Here is James. And the shot fired in by Kankovic, and it's blocked by Kennedy. And that goal was scored with Alana Kennedy off the field of play as she waited to come back on. 1-1. Chelsea pouring forward now in search of the winner. Kankovic. Wrighton. Kerr. And it's cleared away by Kennedy. And then won back well by Mace. Carter. And we are in the 98th minute. But there's still time for Chelsea here. Leopolds, Kirby, James, shot is blocked, Perisic, Kerr pulling wide, Perisic again, Bright is still forward, it's her header, but it's blocked, Leopolds, and City managed to clear, and now Shaw will try and bring it forward, and she was pulled down by Kankovic, and she'll be booked. And the Manchester City fans celebrate that like a goal. Shaw looking to lead the counter-attack, but it was that pull on the arm which was enough to earn Kankovic the yellow card. Hammered high. And the clearance will drop to Hasegawa. Oh, but that's a poor ball, couldn't find Kasparite. And Chelsea here will look to create one more opportunity. And it's long, it's looking for Sam Kerr. Kerr is in, but she can't hit the target. Keating was out very quickly, and she was offside anyway. Sam Kerr denied. We're heading towards the 100th minute. And we've had 10 yellow cards in the game. And two of those have led to red cards for Alex Greenwood and Lauren Hemp. But we still play on. Hasegawa losing out to Wrighton. Chelsea continuing to play with Millie Bright as a centre forward. It's in towards Kerr, but it's beyond Kerr. And it's a goal kick in the end. Well, Gareth Taylor can find the time to smile, or maybe it's a grimace. Emma Hayes would still consider this 2 points dropped, I think. But we still play on. Blackstad will take the throw in. In towards Shaw, but beyond her. Carter. Well, it's been blocked. Mace. Blackstad. And then losing out to Perisic. James. Kirby. Chelsea streaming forward, surely the last attack. The low cross in, almost breaks kindly for Kirby. What a brilliant challenge, and it scrambled away. Carter. Perisic. Kerr leaping with the header. It's off the post. In the 101st minute, Sam Kerr hits the post. And Chelsea that close to winning the game. A great ball in, and a great leap from Sam Kerr as well. And it bounces off the far post, and Emma Hayes thought her team had won it there. And we now have a Chelsea player down. And there was so much happening inside that penalty area. And there was some brilliant defending initially to deny Chelsea a clear sight of goal. This was the ball in from Charles. And it was Wrighton who lost out to Alexandri. And then the cross in from Perisic. And Kurt, the third Chelsea player to strike the woodwork. And Wrighton, who scrambled in the equaliser. Gareth Taylor, we can hear, is urging the officials to blow the full-time whistle. We're now heading towards the 13th minute of added time. Carter will hurl this ball short in the end. And the cross in is claimed by Keating. And that is it. What a game. What a game. It finishes in a draw. Manchester City led for so long with 10 players, with 9 players. Guro Wrighton equalising in the 96th minute. Emily Heaslip, the referee, a central figure, sending off Alex Greenwood just before half-time. And Lauren Hemp in the 81st minute. Chloe Kelly with the opening goal for Manchester City. Seems an age ago now. Guro Wrighton finally equalising 6 minutes into added time. Chelsea hit the bar and post 3 times in the second half. But at the end of all that, it ends with a point apiece. Full time, Manchester City 1, Chelsea 1.